God is a good God, isn't he? He's an almighty, awesome God. We are grateful for this great 83rd Annual Sunday School Missionary and Lecture Board Convention of the Church of God, founded by Jesus Christ Incorporated, under the leadership of Bishop and First Lady Minton, Bishop Davis, Chairman Smith, Presiding Elders Glover, Kemp, Clawson. If I missed any Presiding Elder, I honor you. To the superintendents and to, especially to our beautiful presidents.
Thank you.
They don't have on white tonight, but they're still presidents. And I'll have on white with them tomorrow. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for Evangelist Long, for this beautiful choir, for all of you. It's a nice thing to be able to enter into his gates with thanksgiving.
Yes.
And into his courts with praise. Let us tell him thank you. He's worthy.
Yes, he is.
Thank you, Jesus. And if you feel a little tired or overstuffed on that delectable dinner we had this evening, it was good. Give the cooks a hand. I ate until I wanted no more.
Hello.
And I said to the bishop, Mitchell, he was saying, eat all you want. I said, I have had enough. I said, if I eat any more, you may have to preach. He said, oh, no. So I quit then. But we're having a beautiful time.
Sure, yeah. Sure.
Beautiful hotel. Facilities. Accommodations. I have no complaint.
All right.
And in the Word of God, I have a hiding place.
Yes.
Time is of the essence. Time is important. It's time that whatever we are going to do for Christ, that we would be about our Father's business.
All right.
The presidential day begins tomorrow, as we know it, but it really begins tonight with your general president. And if you have had an opportunity to look at your program, may not have had much time to look at it, but if you had a chance to look at it at all, you will notice that I made good use of the time of the essence being that it was time for the general president to give us a new theme. And the theme is, we are destined to win.
All right.
And I'd like you to say, get personal.
I
am destined,
destined
to win.
To win.
Now, if you can't make yourself proud of you and make yourself knowledgeable of you, please don't fail to come to the altar tonight. Because when you leave this city, I want you to know that you know.
All right.
That you know that you know.
Sure.
In whom you believe that you've truly been born again.
Yeah.
And that you are a winner. When we think of the many things that are happening, it makes you think deeply if you've got any power of thought at all. The incident that happened out in, down in South Carolina, it would make you wonder if you didn't know Jesus. You probably begin to think, some people do, what in the Lord, what's next?
Surely.
But God is in control.
Yes, 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 yes.
And when you know that 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 you know, you are willing anyway.
All right.
I can't lose for the stuff I use. How about you?
Amen.
There is no failure in God. I invite you to look at Romans chapter 8, verse 37. Beautiful. Word of God.
All right.
Romans 8. And it reads like this. Nay, and we would probably say no. In all these things.
Yes, yes.
We are more than.
More than.
Conquerors. Through him that loved us.
Yes.
For I am persuaded.
I am persuaded.
Somebody else say, I am persuaded.
I am persuaded.
That neither death,
neither death.
Nor life.
Nor life.
Nor angels.
Nor angels.
Nor principalities.
Nor principalities.
Nor powers,
no powers,
nor things present,
nor
things to come. Nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us. From the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus,
our Lord.
Destined to win. I am. We are destined to win.
Yes, sir.
With that great fact of knowledge, Paul's writing, we talked about Paul some today, talked about him some on last night. He was a great authority.
Right.
Now, Romans was Paul's greatest work. Is placed first among his 13 epistles in the New Testament.
All right.
While the four Gospels present the words and works of Jesus Christ, Romans explores the significance of his sacrificial death using a question and answer format. Paul records the most systematic presentation of doctrine in the Bible. Romans is more than a book of theology. It is also a book of practical exhortation. I hope that sharing with Paul's sayings and whatever else God shall say through his servant, I exhort you that you will not have the mentality to say, well, if nothing happens, I'm going to make it.
All right. All right.
Because if that's your mentality, you can hang it up.
All right.
Because something is surely going to happen. Every time you pick up the paper, turn on the news, and even if you didn't think you were turning on the news, you turn on a regular program, and here comes some negative news, some sad news.
All right.
Used to be the people on the other side of town. I think I know you might say to President Boston today, you'd say, I think I heard that name. I think I know that person. But now it's your next door neighbor.
Yes. Sure.
Or it may be your bed partner. Sure. We are destined to win in spite of.
All right.
Now, destiny is a predetermined course of events. To be bound or directed. It is the preordained or inevitable course of events considered as something beyond the power or control of man.
Right.
Think about your destiny. It produces an inevitable outcome. The storm clouds keep on rising, the rains will keep falling,
yes.
Murders will keep on happening, but we have an inevitable outcome to know that we are destined to win. I want you to say again, I am a winner.
I am a winner.
Yes, I
am. I'm not serving a loser.
All right.
If I thought that I was serving a loser, I'd dump it.
Yeah.
I'd pitch it.
Yeah.
I'd get rid of it.
Yeah.
But I know in whom I believe.
Yeah.
And I hope and I pray and I trust that every individual here tonight will get to know for yourself.
No.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
You know, we used to go to the mourner's bench. We pray,
yes.
And sometimes we get tired. As youngsters, we jump up and shout a little bit. And sometimes the older folks get back down and pray a little more.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And sometimes we didn't do so much shouting, but we met their approval on the day and say, that's it.
Uh-huh.
But if nobody tells you that's it, it's in my heart. How about your heart? You've got to know. You've got to stand before a just God. And you've got to stand for yourself. Not my sister, not my brother, but you've got to stand for self. And that keeps you from getting upset with other people when they don't hear you. Too upset. Because if you had my key, I'd get very upset when you wouldn't go to prayer meeting, Bible class, Sunday school, YPHU, usher boys, missionary meeting. Because I would be afraid that you would leave me hanging on the outside.
All right.
But since I've got to do this for me, and you've got to do that for you, it's up to you.
Sure.
Yeah. Whether you choose to be a winner.
All right.
Or a loser.
Mm-hmm.
The great orator Winston Churchill says, the destiny of mankind is not decided by material competition.
Sure.
Colossians 3:16 says, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly.
Yes, sir.
In all wisdom.
Yeah.
Teaching and admonishing one another.
Mm-hmm.
In psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Singing with grace in your heart to our Lord and Savior.
Sure
Jesus
sure
Christ.
That.
Again, when we think of the sad salutation regarding the 9 deaths snuffed out in South Carolina. You have questions, perhaps, because you will say, if you can't go to church and bow and pray, where can you go? And so then you better remember that God's word you're going to hide in your heart. If you can get to the church, you ought to be there, but just in case you can't get there.
All right.
The body is the temple of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And whether you're with 1, 2, or 1,002, you can have Jesus.
All right. Yes. All right.
And know you're a winner.
All right.
And you'll have enough. Nay, in all these things, we are not just conquering, barely making it, but we are what? More than. Somebody say more than.
More than.
More than.
More than.
More than conquering.
More than
conquering. Through him that loved us. Does he love you? For I am persuaded, as I read, that neither death nor life, not any of these things, are going to separate me from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. So long as we've got Jesus, we are destined to win.
Yes.
Don't you dare doubt. However much more preaching you hear in this meeting, or how little you hear, when you go home, don't go home with any doubts.
Amen.
And you keep saying to yourself, I'm destined to win. I am a winner.
Yeah.
In spite of.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah to God. So long as we've got Jesus, let us all step into our destiny. Isaiah 54 and 17 tells us that no weapon. How many?
No weapon
that is formed against thee shall prosper. No weapon. From South Carolina, North Carolina, Georgia, Maryland, the District of Columbia,
no weapon.
Shall prosper.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Happy wake up.
And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. I am of his heritage. Everything that God has part of is mine.
All right.
Yes.
I don't look like it to you. That's your problem. I got some mirrors.
Sure.
All right. Amen.
I got one right here.
All right.
And it lets me know when I'm right, and it lets me know when I'm wrong.
Oh, yes. Right. Yes.
All right.
Thank
Hallelujah.
You, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
We look at the mirror at Matthews, and the Bible lets us know that soon we forget what we look like. Get all fixed up. We have a body that comes tomorrow. And I tell ladies that I get a chance to share with, you're not quite sure whether that dress is quite right for church. Amen. Get in front of the mirror and bend over. And look back and see what you can see. We see. And you see That's what funny. I see. Whatever you see,
That's what other people see.
Know what other people see. What you see. And who knows who's going to drop a fan? You got to bend over and pick it up.
Oh, you better watch out.
What you saw in the mirror.
That's what it was.
That is what they see.
That's funny. Amen. Yeah. That's good.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Right from the back side.
Sure.
Well, turn around, look at the front side. Bend over.
Lord have mercy.
Can you see what I see?
Yikes.
You look like a winner. Know what to do with that you know.
All right.
I know the lights will work, but if wisdom doesn't tell me to flip the switch, poor knowledge. As Paul confers regarding the church,
all right,
in Ephesians, he tells us more about how winners walk.
All right.
There was a different walk about winners. You think you're going to lose? My gun's looking on the thumb. Jesus. Biting your nails. Turning your foot in and out. But it's time to know. Now, we've been talking about stepping up, moving up to the next level. Have we gotten to the next level yet? Sometimes we talk about going to the next level, like we not step by step.
Yep, Lord.
But we need to not only step to the next level, but we need to walk.
Yes.
Walk by faith.
All right.
And not by sight.
Yes, yes.
Now in those Ephesian walks, it's not only to the church of Ephesus, but it's to us. It's time to shout it out. Yeah. I need to really know it.
All right. All
to
right.
Not to be fearful.
Yes.
To not be doubtful. But to be fully knowledgeable of where you're going. Mm. First tells us to walk in obedience.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We're to obey those that have rule over us.
Sure.
Yeah.
But sometimes we don't want to obey.
All right.
I'm 3 times 7. Mm-hmm. 27 to carry.
Mm.
Yeah. My daddy's gone. My mama's gone. Don't nobody tell me what to do. Mm. Oh, we have that attitude sometimes.
All right.
When I say we,
some do.
We the human race.
All right.
We church members sometimes. We don't want to obey.
Amen.
Tells us to walk with good works. We got to work the work of he that has sent us.
Yes.
While it's day, because
yes.
Night is coming.
Yes.
And no man can work.
No man can
Amen.
Work. Then he tells us to walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called.
Yes, sir.
We are called into an important vocation. We're not boys and girls and adults, to older people, go to college sometimes and say, what are you majoring in? I ain't decided yet.
Mm-hmm.
Mom and dad is paying the bill, you know. Mm-hmm. Oh, we may have a scholarship. I may have a student loan. I ain't quite decided.
Mm-hmm.
But you better get it together and decide what your vocation is. What are you planning on doing? If you do not, you can do lots of study, receive many good grades, but when you decide later on, it may not be transferable to your area.
Mm-hmm.
It's not lost totally. Because no education is lost, but it will not carry over.
All right.
For the credits that you will need. So walk worthy. Walk not as others.
All right.
It's just that plain in Ephesians. Not as others, not as men pleasers, in the vanity of your mind. Well, if I walk this way, I'm going to get a raise. I'm going to get a promotion. Because Mac Neal looks like he's getting sick. And they're going to need a new superintendent. And if I scratch his back, I might get to be the next superintendent.
All right, step in line. Yeah.
But walk not as men pleasers.
That's right.
But rather please the one that has called you to be a disciple of his. Says, as you walk, he says, put away lying. Kind of believe that. God must detest liars worse than anything else.
Oh, yes.
We say them old bad girls and them old bad boys are prostituting and shooting it up and on dope. But probably some of them are very truthful. But if we're lying, so well, I don't lie like I used to. I just get pushed in the corner and I tell a white lie. But a white lie and a black lie is a lie. And all liars.
All of them.
Black ones, white ones, green, grits of gray, tartreuse. All liars shall have their portion in the lake that burns with fire and brimstone. And a liar, will not even tell me in his sight. That means he just can't stand you. I might tell you I can't stand you, and that don't mean a thing. But if God can't stand you, you in bad shape. You have messed up something bad. So don't walk as men pleasers. In this walk, it says, neither give place to the devil.
That's right.
The devil, our adversary, he is walking, he's coming from to and fro.
Yes.
Seeking whom he may divide. He know he's already got you. He ain't trying, he's trying to get you.
That's right.
He got you, he's happy about that. He's going to try to keep you. But he want to get you that say I'm a winner.
All right.
He want to stop you from winning the race.
All right.
Now there's a writer that tells us about the running of the race and where only one can win.
Amen.
But in this race, every one of us that will pay the price.
Yes.
We can win. We will. Win.
Yes.
Give no place to the devil. He that stole, say, steal no more.
Amen.
Isn't that something? It's sad to say, but that we have to trust the bank or the banker who ain't saying nothing about being saved more than we can the deacon. Of the mother, because when she gets in a tight, we dread. I had to have a little money. And I said I'm going to pay it back. And when I got ready to pay it back, I needed it worse than I did when I borrowed it.
Yeah.
If that has ever happened to you, you don't have to go to hell for it. Repent. Don't steal no more.
No more.
Not a little bit more. No more.
No more.
Say no more.
No more.
I won't steal no more.
No more.
No more. No more.
You can make up your mind you're going to walk this walk. You can be a winner.
Yeah. All right.
Walk in the light. Walk not in the darkness. this a danger. Walking in the dark, God wants his people to walk in the light.
All right.
Walk in love. Love as Christ has loved us. For God so loved the world.
Yes.
That he gave his only begotten son.
Jesus.
When he knew some of us wouldn't take time to say thank you, he just loved us right on. He loved us all the time. He said, let that love be without dissimulation. Mm-hmm. Abhor that is evil. Cleave to that that is right. Mm-hmm. We're just having a little talk so we can be sure.
Be sure.
That you'll enjoy our destiny.
Yes.
Says when you use my mama's, my late mother's old words, circumspectly. She said, I want you to go in there and clean that cabinet, and I want you to clean it circumspectly.
All right.
She meant she didn't want to see not a crumb. That old safe, I want you to clean it circumspectly, and if you clean real quick, she said, all right. I know it would take you at least 15 minutes to do that. Mm-hmm. You can't clean that cabinet or that safe in 5 minutes. Sometimes we get in a hurry and we don't want to take time to live over. To do what ought to be done like it ought to be done. Walk, be filled with the Spirit as you walk and submit yourselves one to another. Husbands, submit yourselves to your wives. Wives, submit yourself to your husbands. To your children. You know why sometimes our children give us such a headache? We don't submit to them. It works both ways.
All right.
Submit one to another. You cuss your child out, he or she will probably do the same thing to you.
Amen.
Well, I don't do that often, but it's just when they blew my cool. Well, when they start cussing you, you blown their cool. But submit yourselves one to another. Then Ephesians 6 tells us to put on what?
The whole
armor. Not a little bit.
The whole.
But the whole.
The whole.
The whole armor.
The whole. All right.
Get down to business. We see, say, brass tacks. Get down to brass tacks. Get down to real business.
All right.
And put on.
Put on.
And take off what you ought to take off.
All right.
Well, she's talking about our dresses and our this and our that. I wasn't particularly talking about it, but we need to take it off, take it off. I wouldn't dare wear this to the beach. And get in the water with it. Now, I can make you feel better to get the water with a rope on like this. Be my guest. We go to some restaurants and say you must have a shirt on, shoes on.
Oh, yeah.
To be allowed to come. I don't want to adhere to that. Well, then go on over to McDonald's, a Burger King, a Wendy's, or somewhere else where you can drive through naked. Well, the church of God founded by Jesus Christ think they better than anybody else. They don't want the women to wear no pants to the conventions.
All right, then.
Do you want to wear your pants here? You may be in heaven when I get there. But remember, you got to walk the walk of obedience.
That's right.
Amen. 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 I seen them women on TV. They got on pants. Maybe their leader did not ask them not to wear pants. You obey those.
That's right.
That have rule over you. It ain't gonna kill you.
No, it's not. No, it's not.
If you can't pull off your pants 3 hours for church,
Amen.
You got a real problem.
Amen.
You just got to wear some pants every day. Wait till you get out of church. As soon as you get out of church, pull off your dress, hang it up, and save it till the next time.
Amen.
But just be sure you're obeying.
That's right.
Obey.
I'm trying to help us to get the help.
That's right.
Yes. Yes.
All right.
We're on our way, but we haven't gotten here yet.
That's right, that's right.
And it's only what we do for Christ that's going to last.
That's right.
Well, get to it, lady. That's what I'm going to do. Are we going to do all this walking? All this you're talking about? The Bible tells us come out as a reason together.
Reason, reason.
Sometimes we hoot and holler, oh, Lord, what got the matter? Jonah swallowed the whale. Yeah! It said the whale swallowed the time. Jonah swallowed the whale. Sounding good, don't know what I said, but because it had a good sound to it. Yeah! But you need to know what you amen into.
That's right, that's right, that's right.
It is in the word of God that we got a hiding place.
That's right.
Choose ye this day whom you would serve. Make up your mind. As for me and my house, I will
serve the Lord.
Oh my God.
Thank you, God.
Servant half handed me.
No, 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 no.
But you got to lay aside.
Everyone.
Not just what you heard your preacher say, but you got to lay aside every weight. I never read that was a sin, but if it's a weight. Lay it aside. Get rid of it. Kick it to the curb. Lay aside every way and the sin that does so easy to be sin.
Run.
And if we'll do that, we are sure winners.
Yes, you will. Yes,
and if we can't do it, we are sure losers.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'd rather have Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Than anything that this world affords today. Not just saying it because I'm a general president, but it's because I love the Lord. With my whole heart, mind, and spirit.
Amen.
And I think when I sit down tonight, you will know. You'll think, you'll be concerned of how you're going to be sure that you're going to be a sure winner.
Amen.
Man is a loser in himself, herself. We can't make it without the Lord. Whether we know it's a sin, if somebody tells you it's a sin, you say, well, I don't believe it, but it's better to lay it aside than to take a chance.
Yes, amen.
It would be late when you get up and go before the Lord in the final analysis. And you say, nobody didn't tell me. And then there comes up somebody looking right to the eyeball. To the eyeball. Body says, finally! All these things that Paul said, that Mary Thomas said, finally, my brethren.
Yes.
Finally, after all this walking and all this talking, all this chatting, and all this dressing and all this undressing, and all the old men, all the new men, finally, my brethren, sisters too, be strong.
No.
I want you all to kind of raise your shoulders a little bit. Say, I'm strong. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on how much? The whole armor of God. That he may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I had fun with one of our beautiful sisters today. I said, how you doing? She said, I'm hanging in there. I said, I didn't tell you to hang. I just told you to stand. Mm-hmm. Stand, therefore. Stand. So put on that whole armor. That you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. Ain't no time to be worrying about the deacon and the mother and the president of the nursing board, the usher board, and missionary board, and all the other boards. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Yes.
Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that he may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand, do what?
Stand.
Stand, therefore.
Thank you, God.
Have your loins girt about with truth, then, having on the breastplate of righteousness. And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. When Jesus was getting ready to go, he said, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world gives. Give I unto you. My God, he left with us a deep set of peace. Glory to God that all the devils in hell can't disturb. But it takes God. Because sometimes people say, you done got on the last nerve. Those of us said, you done pushed the wrong button. But I'm glad about that peace he left with me. And he said, above all.
Above all.
Said, finally, before I said, now, told y'all this now, above all. Taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all, not some,
all
the fiery darts of the wicked. You can do it. Say, I can do it. Because I'm a winner. And take the helmet of salvation.
Yes.
And the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God.
Yes.
Now it's in the Word of God that we've got a hiding place.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
And the writer tells us to study.
Study.
To show yourselves approved unto God.
Yes. Yes, sir.
A workman that needs to not be ashamed of what? Well, that ain't the way John Blue explained it, but rightly. We want to be able to rightly search the scriptures.
Yes.
For in them.
In them.
We have eternal life. down their prayer.
Amen.
But if your heart is fixed,
yes,
and your mind is truly made up,
yes,
that you, if you have repented of your sin, where the Lord comes while you're on your knees, you're in the amen corner, on the job, or just riding along cooling. Or you're just taking a cruise with God. You're just cruising.
Yes.
Just enjoying life.
Yes.
Wherever you go.
Ever.
Take the Lord along with you.
Oh, yes.
Everywhere you go, you're going to need it.
Yes. You're gonna need
him. You're gonna need him.
Yes.
Well, I'm smart. Yes. I've been to school. I got this and I got that. And I said, you got enough degrees that the wall won't even hold them up.
Amen.
You still got to get it right with God.
That's right.
Get right with God and do it now.
Hallelujah.
Get right with God and he'll show you how. Get right with God. We've tried to tell you how.
That's right.
We talked about the Spirit today.
Yes.
All these beautiful Spirit of God. Without the Spirit of God, we are none of
us. That's the word. That's
glory.
Yes, sir.
I'm his.
Yes.
I ain't got the hope about it.
My Lord.
Amen.
I got to suppose and will be. I'm his.
Yes.
He's mine.
No, sir.
And he's so good and he's so broad, and you can say the same thing.
Amen.
He said, if you don't know me now, come unto me, all that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I'm meek and lowly of heart. And ye might
shall find rest
unto your son.
Oh, yes.
May God bless every one of you.
Hallelujah.
May heaven smile upon you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus paid it all.
Yes, he did.
Hung up all of my hang-ups. Hang up all of your and our hang-ups. Now let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Get rid of all your mess. She ain't talking to me. Well, good.
Glory, hallelujah.
I had some mess. Well, lady said one time, she don't. Ain't too much of preachers because they ain't never done nothing much. They ain't never done this and never done that. But if you don't claim to have done anything, we were all born in sin. And shaped in iniquity.
Yes, sir.
And the same hot hell that's going to be hot for prostitutes,
well,
it's going to be for those that will fail to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Savior.
Yes.
Don't put off until tomorrow.
Don't
do it.
What you can do today. Is there one single person in this building that does not yet know Jesus Christ? If there is one, would you just raise your hand? Well, I know him, but I ain't been sanctifying all that other stuff. But we need to come out from among them. And be each separate. Be as clean and as pure as you know how to be. Turn it all over to Jesus.
Yes, sir.
He'll make it right for you. If you are saved and you are sanctified.
All right.
The gift of the Holy Ghost is a promise.
Amen.
And it's for every one of us here.
Yes, yes.
It's not just for the old folks. And it's not just for the little children. But it's for all of us in between. It's great joy in serving the true and living God. I get joy when I just think about what he's done for me. God has been so good to me. He made my way.
Thank you, sir.
I don't have to walk for faith. Ain't that wonderful? Should we say sometimes we have an old boy, they have a big steam car, and they just hardly get along? I have to do that. Because Jesus said he's the way, the truth, and the life. And no man come to the Father but by him. In 2013, I was said to have had a heart attack. 2014, I was diagnosed with cancer. 2015, I'm happy. Last July, and I loved that man so much.
Amen.
And he loved me so much, and I go by his picture just about every day, and I say, good morning, honey, I love you. When you live right before each other,
yes.
When the Lord calls one home, you don't have to worry. Be good to each other.
That's right. Yes.
Will you all do that?
Yes.
Be good to each other. If you know somebody don't like you, love the devil out of them.
Yes, sir.